Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Rob Blanchflower Connected Careers or Connected Franchise series here in Madden 15. Now, before we continue on the series, we got a little bit of bad news in real life concerning Rob Blanchflower. He actually got cut from the Steelers' final roster of 53 players. However, he was brought back by the Steelers for their practice squad for the upcoming season. So he is still a Pittsburgh Steeler. We just won't see him on the field with the team unless there are injuries and they take him off the practice squad and back onto the roster of 53 players. So, I don't know, kind of like what's going on with him right here, being a backup third string tight end through this season, which hasn't really panned out well. You see Roethlisberger's thrown for over 3,000 yards, 20 touchdowns, 10 picks, but yet the record only shows 3 wins for these guys. However, they've got a real good performance going on in Cincinnati here, up 24-0 at this point in the third quarter. Looks like they are rolling to a victory, right? Well, hold on a minute, not so fast. Cincinnati comes back and ties it, gets it to overtime, and then wins in overtime, eventually with a field goal. So a 24-0 lead is not even safe with the Steelers squad. They squander that and lose 27-24 to the Cincinnati Bengals. Ouch. That pretty much sums up the season right there. Although we haven't been getting leads like that and only to lose them, we just haven't really been in games much. So that 27-24 loss, we're now 3-9-1, taking on the 6-7 Falcons. There's been plenty of times and opportunities to right the ship here against teams that have had losing records, but we just haven't been able to do it. So here's Blanchflower on the field making a catch, and it's a first down catch at that. Trying to make a comeback here, down 20-17, try to take the lead, and Blanchflower actually gets in there for a catch. Had to highlight that, right? Replay and all. All right, looking pretty good when he gets the game time there, but it's the second straight overtime loss. There it is, Matt Ryan to Harry Douglas to end the game in overtime. So Tomlin is not liking this. They have 2 close calls, but yet 2 more losses added to the schedule as things are winding down in this horrific season for the Steelers. This one here, a 33-27 final. The touchdown in overtime gives the Falcons the victory, and they pull even at 7-7. Steelers still looking for their 4th win of the season, and they've only got a couple weeks to do that. So they take on the 10-4 Chiefs. That's not going to get any easier. Let's see how this goes. At least it's a home game. Oh, we're down 28-10 in the third quarter. Blanchflower on the field, but they're not throwing to him. That is a nice pass to Matt Spaeth, however. The second string tight end is going to make a play right there. And Tomlin's like, okay, at least we got a play going right. Well, it didn't end so well. They get absolutely thumped by the Chiefs, 56-13. Roethlisberger just kind of staring aimlessly into the crowd there after that one. Not much to do. In this matchup, they just were no match. I think they used all the energy they had in those 2 overtime games and just really had nothing left in the tank for this one. And it showed. They're down and out, losing 56-13. The Chiefs showed no mercy on the Steelers in this game. So it's another game against the Bengals, a rematch of that game we blew a 24-point lead in. Hopefully we can do better here in the snow in Pittsburgh. We're going to call on the Bumblebee throwback jerseys or uniform sets once again, hoping maybe we can actually finish a game out against the Bengals this time around. You look at the AFC North standings, Cleveland on top, Pittsburgh bringing up the rear, and Cincinnati there in third place. So not really playing for much here other than pride. Here's Blanchflower making a catch on 3rd and 6, but he can't turn up the field. So on 4th and 5, they're going to go for it, and that's going to be a first down. At least they get a first down on that play. Continuing their 2-minute drill drive. Yeah, they're not going to tie the game or anything, but they'd like to get down the field. And look at this. Blanchflower putting in the extra effort on that route. He had to break it off several times. Finally gets open for his quarterback and makes a nice catch, and then gets dumped in the snow for his troubles. Let's see here. Roethlisberger finally does connect with him, but Blanchflower probably ran the equivalent of the field there, just trying to get open, and does a nice job improvising for his quarterback here. Play action, look out! Roethlisberger is destroyed. Luckily, His own player falls on the football, so they still have it. And now just 47 seconds left. This pass to Blanchflower. Nice catch. He leans over and grabs that one, keeps his balance, and makes the catch. That was pretty impressive right there. If you consider the elements and everything, 4th and 3, they got to have this right here. It's to Blanchflower, and he's hoping he can make a one-on-one move there, but he cannot. They will lose the football on downs. So Blanchflower got involved a little bit here late in this game as they were trailing, and he showed some good flashes, but Cincinnati will win once again, this time 33-12. And that is how your season is going to end for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Just 3 wins. It should set them up in great position to get a high draft pick. But this 2014 season has been something to forget. That is for certain. This one was a headache and will not be one they will look back on fondly. Just 3 wins. Even a tie in there. It was just an ugly season. So we're hoping for much better the next time around. We got a pretty good roster. We should be able to win some games. I just think this simulation stuff is some BS when you're not on the field most of the time. We really got hammered there. So the Seahawks apparently are back-to-back champions, taking out the New England Patriots 34-10 in the Super Bowl. So here we are working the offseason now. We still get the chance to be able to go ahead and practice and train, get that XP, and build ourselves up. So now look at what they do in free agency. Spaith is gone. Starter Heath Miller is gone in free agency, so they bring in John Carlson, and they bring in Kellen Davis. So still Blanchflower looking at third on that roster as far as his overall. However, when we move into the preseason here, he is listed at the top right of your screen as second string tight end. So maybe they're just disregarding the overall, and they're going to give him a shot there as second string. So as we are simming through the preseason, we see we've had one cut there, so it's just Carlson, Blanchflower, and Kellen Davis, and there you go. He is on the depth chart at the second spot for tight end. So in 2 tight end sets, he's going to get a lot of playing time. This is great news for Blanchflower. So we are looking at week 3 of the preseason, which we are also going to advance right through, doing our practice sessions, doing all that, building it up, but here we go. Game 4 of the preseason, the last tune-up, and he gets in and makes a catch right here against Tampa Bay in a 3-3 game. Let's see what he can do continuing on. 1st and goal. This pass is going to be to Blanchflower for a touchdown. That's his 2nd preseason touchdown. Now, he hasn't had one in regular season yet because he really hasn't had that many chances, but there he is getting another preseason touchdown, and things are looking promising here in preseason play for him, as they want to see if he can really handle that role. Well, let's keep it coming. Keep throwing the ball to him, and hopefully he'll prove right to you that he should be on the field more often than not. This is going to be over the middle, and he's going to make a catch. Very close to first down yardage. They'll probably mark him 2 yards short. 1st and 10 situation right here, and he's going to get the ball again. Turn up field and fight through 3 defenders. Getting very close. There's an injury, but it's not Blanchflower. It's one of the defenders that he ended up meeting head on, and he is not getting up very quickly. 2nd and 1 right here, and Blanchflower is going to make that catch. Nice little catch there, leaning forward to get it. So he's got that one, and he's got a little bit of a celebration in him too. Look at that. Check it out. Makes the catch and secures the football. So doing everything they want out of him right now. 2nd and 5, pump fake. Going to go to him there on his 2nd move, and he is open once again for a 1st down. That should be, I think, his 5th or 6th catch on the day, and things are going well for Blanchflower here in the final preseason tune-up. 1st and 10. Here we are up 10-3. 3rd quarter. He's going to make another catch there for minimal yardage, but he's done it yet again. That will be catch number 7 there, you see, for 51 yards. I don't know why Tomlin's upset other than they didn't get a 1st down. 1st and goal right here. Quick throw, not to Blanchflower, and maybe that was the problem. It's picked off. Ah, shoot, that didn't work out very well. So it is picked off, and they don't get any extra points there. Tacked on, and Tampa actually comes back and takes the lead, but hold up. Blanchflower makes a nice catch there. If he could have just turned up the sideline and kept his momentum inbounds, he might have been gone, or at least well down the field, but he does secure the 1st down catch either way. Nice job there, solid play. So 1st and 10, down by 3 at this point. Blanchflower reaches up and catches that one. Comes down really close to the 1st down, as we're under 5 minutes to play now. Second and one. After the results of that play, he's got a chance for another first down and catches it. Gets hit hard, but he secures the catch. So that's the two-minute warning, and they have a chance to, at the very least, tie this game. Oh, we got a sack? No, we got rid of the ball just in time, but that will be fourth and six. Field goal attempt coming up to tie the game. Oh, boy, what everybody wants, a tie game and potential overtime in the fourth preseason game. No way. But they get the ball back here. 51 seconds left. Must have been a turnover. Blanchflower, big catch right there. Does not want to go down. He stretches out for the first down. Tampa takes a timeout, knowing they might be in trouble here as they are just about in field goal range. They're going to want to punch this a little closer with the running game. And on second and one, they get that first down. So it looks like they can just center things here, run the clock out, and maybe kick a game-winning field goal. Avoid overtime in preseason. Nobody wants that. The kick is up, and it is good, and the Steelers will win the game. That's not that important, but what is important is Blanchflower looked really good in this game, showing some flashes of what might come here if he's playing a lot in the regular season, and it looks like he will be at that second tight end spot. He should be out there a lot because they're going to run a lot of two tight end sets. This team, the Steelers, they do that all the time. That's their bread and butter. So we've covered a lot of ground as far as time in the series because he really wasn't seeing the field. I mean, we're already into the second season in the fourth episode. That's a flash there, but look at that. 11 catches for 91 yards, 8.2 average. Blanchflower showed up for this game, and hey, maybe fantasy owners should look for him in this 2015 season. Just saying, he might be a stud under the radar, tight end for everyone to pick up. He's certainly worth a late round look there, I would think. So there you go, Blanchflower. Looking very promising going into the opener. We'll have to see how the Steelers use him against the Chargers, but it'll be on the road in San Diego to start the 2015 season. Can hardly wait to see Blanchflower getting more playing time. We'll see you next time, guys. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.